The most important question in the history which gives a sense to the life is how we humans inhabited the earth. Who was the first human being and what were his attributes? And the importance of this question can be judged from the life of a child whose parents are unknown. The most important thing in the life of this child would be to find his parents. What were the attributes of his parents, where his parents came from, and what they wish for him to become, and what they want him to follow which path. The question that where this human being came from, how he inhabited this earth, is the most important, the most debated and ever talked question in the history of mankind. There is one predominant concept of creation throughout the history, that is the divine creation of human being. And that means that human beings are created by God. Although the concept of who God is varies among different civilizations, this concept of creation is there among humans from the very beginning till now. Only after 1800 centuries, after the scientific boom, there were theories that presented gave an alternative view about human creation. But despite that, the majority concept is still that human beings are created by God. During the course of civilizations, many alternative beliefs and myths were presented. Some of them were lost with the civilization, and the most vibrant one still continue till today. In the first part of this video, I will tell you what was the concept of human creation in these different civilizations. In my first video, I have explained about the Greek gods. So in Greek society, they worshipped many gods. These gods had characters and attributes like humans as well. For example, love, hatred, enmity, and friendship. So among gods, one god called as Prometheus created man out of mud, and the goddess Athena breathed life into this creation. Here we see another common pattern repeating in ancient creation myths, that the spirit is given to the body so that it will become alive. But the story doesn't finish here. The ruling god at that time was called as Zeus. Zeus was not very fond of man, so he punished man and Prometheus. Punishment that Zeus inflicted on man was to create Pandora. Pandora was the first woman. Zeus gave Pandora a jar as a gift and told her not to open the jar. The jar was full of misfortune, disease, and plagues, but at the bottom there was also hope. Now you can guess very easily that the lid of the jar was opened and all the evils occupied the earth, except for hope, which remained inside the jar. The Roman civilization were quite influenced by the Greeks. The gods of Romans were similar to the god of Greeks. That means the Romans believed in many gods. The Romans believed that their lifestyles comes from gods, and that there was a force of greater being that created and continued to control the mankind, their faith, worship, and daily lifestyle. Roman thought that before the creation of earth, sea, or heaven, only chaos existed, a shapeless, unorganized matter where there was no sun, no moon, and no air. The elements existed without any form. All things in the world were opposite and at conflict with one another. Finally, a nameless God, a natural high power, resolved all conflicts. He separated heaven from earth, organizing all things in a balanced union. This separation caused the highest sphere to be made a heavenly vault. The next lower region was filled with air, light, and a substance. Then came the earth, which sank down under its own weight and was circled by sea. This God organized the earth into five different sections. Only the two temperate regions were livable. The water was filled with fishes, the land with wild animals, and the air with birds. But these animals lacked intelligence. The Roman thinks that the man was born either from a divine seed from the God who created the earth, or Prometheus molded an image from the gods from a clump of earth. Roman believed whoever created man intended for them to be greater than other animals, built with their head high and gaze directed to the sun, instead of with their head down and eyes focused downward like other animals. The ancient Egypt was also a very rich civilization. They also believed in many gods, and every god performed different functions. The ancient Egyptian believed that there was an early god called as Autumn. Autumn is known as the creator god. Autumn had two offsprings, Shu and Tefnut, who had set out to create the world. As his children were gone so long, Autumn became very concerned. So he removed his eye and sent it in search of them. While his eye was gone, Autumn sat alone on hill in the midst of chaos and contemplated eternity. Shu and Tefnut returned with the eye of Autumn, and their father, grateful of their safe return, shed tears of joy. These tears dropping onto the dark fertile earth of the Benben gave birth to man and woman. Hindu and Hinduism is one of the earliest civilizations and has a rich culture history. In Hinduism, the universe is millions of years old. In line with Hindu belief, they believe in reincarnation. The reincarnation belief means that the non-physical essence of living being begins a new life in a different physical form or body after biological death. In Hinduism, the universe is millions of years old. The universe we live in is not the first, or indeed the last universe. For Hindus, the universe was created by Brahma, the creator, who made the universe out of himself. After Brahma created the world, it is the power of Vishnu which preserves the world and human beings. As part of the cycle of birth, life and death, it is Shiva who will ultimately destroy the universe. This is not necessarily as bad as it might sound, because it allows Brahma to start the process of creation all over again. The Hindu concept of creation of life is that a lotus flower grew from Lord Vishnu's navel with Brahma sitting on it. Brahma separated the flower into three parts: the heavens, the earth, and the sky. Out of loneliness, Brahma split himself into two to create a male and a female. From this male and female, all beings were created. Another story makes reference to life coming from the cracking of an enormous egg, which is the life from which the universe is born.